So welcome everybody to this first program in the year 2021, and it is fantastic to have Dr. Nandita Palshetkar. She is the most glamorous, most vivacious, totally ground to earth, so friendly, such a fantastic human being, and I don't think we could have had a better start for this year. So Nandita, over to you. Please, we are waiting to listen to your mantra so that we can improve our lives.
I think, Sangeeta, thank you so much. It's such a pleasure to be here. And I've prepared a small presentation so that I can just take you through the different, incidences which have colored my life. And I'm going to share my screen so that we can, do that.
At the same time, Dr. Nandita ma'am, you can view yourself in a gallery view, but you are spotlight for now.
I need to reduce my thing, otherwise I can't.
Reduce your what?
No, it's okay. I wanted to. It's not playing. Yeah. So, you know, friends, when Sangeeta approached me that for this out of box thing, so I thought, let me talk about what are our life skills and life successes that all of us here have achieved. So I thought, let me talk about my life, my mantras that have said. And actually what this group has actually created over here is living history. It's a living memory which you have created in this group. And I think, Sangeeta, it's amazing. And there was this beautiful poet, Muriel Racer, who actually said that universe is made of stories, not of atoms. And that is what you have created over here. It's a front porch society of the century. You know, it was in the 19th century that there used to be a front porch with a swing, and people used to sit on the swing, and people used to just walk around, and they used to come on this porch and, you know, used to give pies and have a cup of tea and then just discuss, talk about stories, you know, the war stories, etc. And that way, it was a living memory, a living history that happened. And this is what you've created here today. It's, you know, some people talk about funny stories, some are thoughtful, and sometimes profound stories can be heard. And it's really nice that people take time to hear each other, to come together and to connect with one another. I think it's beautiful what we have created here. And I want to really think that this is one big family which we've created, and we've all come together, and it's fantastic. Let me start with my childhood. You know, I really loved to read, and I was so fond of library books, and I was not allowed because I would not study and I would read library books. So I would read under a blanket, you know, I would go under a blanket with a torchlight and read library books. I was so crazy about reading books. And of course, my parents probably knew about it, but that's how I got this number -6, because I really loved to read. And my whole childhood when I was growing up was elections. My father fought his first election in 1966 when my brother was born. He didn't get his ticket in 1961 because it was reserved for the women, and Pratibha Dai Patil got it that year because she was a woman, and he didn't get the ticket, and he got it in 1966 and he won the election. And you know, there have been a lot of campaigns and everything that I've grown up with. And one thing I want to tell you, we won a lot of elections, we lost a lot of elections. And what this has actually colored my life is that we got love from all quarters. And there used to be strangers in my house and people from all strata of life, you know, simple people to the top-notch people. And that actually made me very comfortable with different kinds of people. Meaning I can connect to a person who cleans my house, to a person who is in the top office of the country. So I think that kind of exposure was really wonderful. Another thing that I really wish to share is, in one of the elections, I remember we had lost the election, we came to know, and we packed all our bags, and in the middle of the night we just left. You know, we were devastated. My father had mortgaged a lot of property. We had lost everything, and we just came back to Bombay. And I remember how he struggled out of it, and he fought out of it, and he won, came out of it and won the next elections. So I think I've seen that struggle, I've seen everything. So what I have learned from him is you have your highs and you can be at the bottom also. So it should not go to your head, because power is very, very temporary. You can be at the highest level of the seat and the next day you can be a nobody. So you need to have people around you who connect with you, whether you are somebody or a nobody. And I think that is a very, very important lesson, which was I really learned, you know, very early in my life. And I think the most important thing is that you need to treat everybody with respect and dignity, whatever they work, whatever they do, whoever they are. And one thing that I realized very early in the life, that a lot of sacrifices our family made for my dad. You know, he was never there during our school life. Like if I was performing or my brothers were performing, dad was never there in any of the functions. My mother took his place. But imagine if my mother would have told him, Hi. Sorry, my granddaughter is here. If my mother would have insisted, ki no, today my son is performing, my daughter is performing, you have to be there in school, he would have never achieved this greatness which he did. So somewhere down the line, I think this new generation which is there, which talks about quality time, that the children need this and the children need that, have to understand that there are sacrifices to be made if you need to achieve greatness. I mean, it's very difficult to balance work, life, and achievements. So you need to be understanding about all these things. So I would make a sincere appeal to the younger generation that understand each other's ambitions, and help each other out. What has happened, Rohan? I'm sorry. This has got stuck, I think.
You can just click on the screen and press next button.
It's gone. Yeah. So there was a lot of spiritual influence on my life. We had a lot of, you know, spiritual gurus who came into my life. And my father always had a guru. Initially, when he was young, he had Sri Dattabai. And actually, this is a very, I don't know whether, you know, a lot of y'all may not believe it, but when I was young, Dr. Sri Dattabai had got me a doll from Thailand. And he said, okay, bacha, when you're going to become big, I was trying to put this doll into the glass, removing it from its glass container. And today I do test tube babies. You know, I mean, my mother talked about it, but it's something like that. But this is the man in the center is Patil, Patil from Shankar, Shankar Patil from Shegaon. And he is from Shegaon, Gajanan Maharaj. He's mentioned, his family is mentioned in the Pothi of Gajanan Maharaj. And my father went to Shegaon and he actually got a vision and he quit politics in one day. He just went to Shegaon and he quit politics because Gajanan Maharaj came in his dream and told him to go into education. And can you imagine a man who's in politics, who has a fantastic career in politics, he just quit it overnight because his guru told him to quit it. And you can see the rest is history. My mother was very upset at that point, but look at where it led him. Today, I mean, he is, I don't know whether if he had become a chief minister or whatever, if he had got this kind, his students are all over the world. D.Y. Patil University is all over the world. So I think he was guided correctly by his guru. And I believe in that spirituality. So we really believe up. And while growing up, it was sibling love. You know, let me tell you an incident. My brother, the older one, he's not in this picture because I couldn't locate a picture with him so fast. But he and my neighbor's son, they fought. And his sister and me were angry And we actually fought in the building, pulling each other's hair because the brothers were fighting. And we are fighting and these boys are sitting and chatting and watching us fight, pulling each other's hair. So that was the strong sibling love that we have. And there was some sant who had come to my house and given me a japa that you must say this japa for your brother. I still say it when I'm traumatized or when I'm, you know, when I need to meditate, I say that japa. That is the kind of love that we have and all of us have. And remember, I think Theodore Roosevelt said this, comparison is the thief of joy. And my parents never compared the four of us. And that is why all four of us have gone into different fields. And I think it's very important as parents never to compare your children, never to compare them to each other. It's very, very important. Another thing that is important, which you must teach your children, is a satiety center. You can buy a shoe for 500 rupees, for 50,000 rupees. And today, Nita Ambani has a shoe of 5 crore, yeah. But you need a satiety center because you can get joy in small things. And I think that is what brings happiness to people also. I've met a lot of great people in my life. And what I have noticed in great people is their humility. All the great people are really very humble. You know, even today, if you talk to my father and ask him, who is he? What is he? He'll say, I'm a farmer. And I think that is something that is beautiful. Another thing I would like to tell you about P.V. Narasimha Rao. He was our prime minister between 91 to 96. I had met him somewhere in the early 80s. It was just post a loss in the election. And he was so down. I mean, I had met him and he was really very upset and very depressed. And, you know, he became the prime minister in 91. For a couple of years after that, I couldn't fathom that I had actually met this man a couple of years ago, because defeat can completely ruin you and the win can completely change your personality. So I think this is a lesson to be learned, that even if you're defeated, don't bother with it. You are going to bounce back and you are going to be fantastic. So you should not let defeat bother you like that. Medical college, amazing journey. It developed my love for gynec. My father did come to Nair to check my name on the merit list. I actually stayed in the hostel in the exam going term, actually to go out with Pradeep. So that, because in the house, there was absolutely no freedom. But when I was in the hostel, I could, you know, go out with Pradeep in the evenings. I was going steady with him and really had a freak out time. And I used to study double, you know, because I used to feel guilty that I'm going out with him. So I used to come back and really study very hard. And then I got married in my internship and did my residency. And I had Rohan when I was doing my residency. I think I must say thank you to Dr. Purandre, Dr. Lopez, and Dr. KK Deshmukh, and Dr. Anil Bhosle, my registrar, because that was the time they really helped me out. And it was a wonderful experience because I had planned to do, my husband was a businessman and he wanted to have a child. Let me tell you about an incident that happened in my first MBBS and which gave a clarity of values. I think this is a very important concept in any person's life, having clarity of values. I had just got admission in first MBBS and we were all having fun. We were bunking left, right and center. It used to be 1.5 years, you know. 100 of us used to go for a movie. I remember Blue Lagoon was released and we were at Sterling watching the movie. And then suddenly the exams came and we were being given forms. And I didn't have enough attendance. And parents were called. My father came to Dr. Lata Mehta, I remember, in the NAD department. And she said to my father, your daughter doesn't have attendance. So what should I do? I can't give her the form. So my father told her, please don't give her the form. I just looked at him aghast. He said she doesn't value the admission that she's got. A person has missed out because she's got a medical school admission. Please don't give her the form. Let her lose 6 months. She doesn't value it. And of course, Lata Mehta gave me the form, but that's the lesson I learned, that you must value what you get. And I think that's very, very important. Trust and belief, these are my people who had trust and belief. You know, when I had my child, and my mother-in-law really took care. She was a wonderful woman. She loved me like a child. And I was just 23, 24, you know, when I had my child. I was very young. And I had gone back to work, and then she passed away when Rohan was just a year old. I had to leave my studies and go back. And I had taken a break of 2 or 2.5 years, and Dr. KK Deshmukh, she called me back. She was my savior, my godmother, everything. She had trust and belief in me that this girl is capable of doing something. And I think everyone needs somebody like that in their life. She one day called me and she said, Nandita, तुला देवानी दिलेला आहे, तुला एवढा दिलेला आहे, तू हुशार मुलगी आहेस, तू परत ये. And she called me back into JJ Hospital and I continued my MD. And I think the lessons that I learned with her and Dr. Purandre is amazing. And these are all my JJ people who supported me and gave me what I needed, the trust and belief in me when I really needed it most. Datta, Anil were my registrars at that time, and they really, really supported me. There were two angels in my life at that time. You know, I was a non-medico household. I didn't even remember Pitocin when I came back. And Rishikesh and Dr. Virkud actually were the angels in my life who taught me. I may be the first MD student who took help from them, took tuitions from them to pass my MD. And it was just 3 months, and believe me, it was amazing. Dr. Virkud taught me obstetrics. Dr. Rishikesh taught me gynecology, and I was able to give my exams. I'm telling you, if I had 1 year with them, I would have walked away with the gold medal. What fabulous teacher. And with C.N. Purandre, with K.K. Deshmukh, with Dr. Jasmine Lopez and Suvarna, I think it would have been really wonderful. But thank you very much. And I think you need these kind of angels and mentors in your life. Let me tell you the story about my son. You can see Rohan, he was just 14 years old and he has gone bald. You know, a 14-year-old going total alopecia at that age, when you're looking for girlfriends, you are having friends, it's total loss of confidence. It was devastating for me as a mother. And imagine for that child. But the other day when we were doing a mother son session with Nagpur OBGYN Society, he said, you know what, my parents gave me a lot of moral support. And I think that is what we need to give our children, unconditional support, unconditional belief in them. And we were able to support him through this. His hair came back, but it was the stress of the 10th standard. Can you believe it? That performance pressure. And today also, if he has exams or any performance pressure, he still loses hair. But I think the belief that you have in your child, the moral support. So this kind of support to your children is very, very important. And this is my mantra to you, that belief and moral support. You know, if my son commits murder, I will be on his side and say he did not commit it. I'm a mother who's completely besotted and devoted to my child and to my family. So I think that kind of loyalty is very, very important. Out of the box thinking is really, really important in your life. You know, when I was in college, it was contraception was a big thing that time. And conception was also happening on the side. There was technique, fabulous surgeons doing operating, you know, Dr. Purandre, Dr. Adidastur talking about forceps, Dr. Purandre talking, doing fabulous surgeries. And there was technology on the other side, laparoscopy, IVF, you know, fetal medicine. Then whether to get into clinical practice or specialization. When I finished my MD, that was my choices that I had. And I decided to go into IVF, which was my, you know, fashion, my futuristic vision. And I joined up hands with Dr. Pai. And I think I've never looked back. And we've always, you know, looked at different technologies, what is happening, and gotten a lot of new things. And that futuristic vision is very important if you want to be successful, if you want to get new things in your life. And today, like, you know, the most exciting part is genetics. Believe me, genetics is going to change the entire way we function. Genetic therapy is going to come in, and the entire way of treating patients, the entire surgical technology is going to change with genetics coming in and you playing around with genes and treating patients in a different way completely. One thing which my father taught me, you know, one day I'd come home and I was exhausted. I'd been working for more than 12 to 14 hours. And he said, "Are you passionate about what you do? Do you love your work?" I said, "Of course I love my work." So he said that if you love your work, if you're doing something with passion, you cannot be tired. It can only energize you. And this has been my mantra in life. And remember, friends, if you do something with passion, with love, and you love it, you enjoy what you're doing, it cannot make you tired, and just enjoy what you're doing. And that is something that is fantastic. My mother was a fabulous lady. And, you know, she was the most loving person. And what I realized from her was the most loving person in the room wins. She was fabulous. And empathy. She could connect with people. And I realized as a doctor, you, the most important quality, or as a human being, the most important quality is empathy. You know, I always put myself in my patient's position. What if she was my sister? What if she was my mother? How would I treat her? And I think if we do that to our patients, if we connect with them, it will be beautiful. You know, if you connect with your people, and believe me, all, I mean, I was reading Robin Sharma's book the other day. He's got a lovely masterclass going on the YouTube. And he said that all the greats, all the legends whom he teaches and he has taught, he realized the most important thing that makes them really big, the Amazon CEO, the Bill Gates, everybody, they are very loving people. They connect with their people, and that's what makes them great. And I think it's very, very important to be loving to your people in your organization. If you love people, you know, they will be with you. They are your people who will stand with you. So I think it's a very important quality one must develop. And of course, the divine bank balance, which my father talks about every time. The divine bank balance, which you must have. Yes, your bank balance is important, but as you go in life, your divine bank balance is very important. You need to create that by doing good deeds, by doing good karma. We are all fortunate today to have achieved a status in life where society has given us a lot. It's time to give back. And I think all of us are in that position to give back. So let us work to build our divine bank balance. I think what he always says, sow good thoughts, you will reap good actions. If you reap good actions, if you sow good actions, you will reap good habits. And if you sow good habits, you will reap good character. And if you sow good character, you will reap good destiny. And that is something that's very beautiful, and all of you must do that. And I think we've been very lucky. We've had fabulous mentorship. I remember Dr. C.N. Puranre telling us that, oh, there's a complication. Bawal has been opened, put my name on the surgery. I think we had fabulous teachers like this who were willing to take the fall for our mistakes, and we must do the same. So thank you, Dr. Lopez. Thank you, Dr. Puranre. Thank you, Dr. KK Deshmukh. I think that's wonderful. all my MOGS mentors. I think that's fantastic. The tea party which we had when I was the president, and all these greats had come, and you know, we were able to spend time with them and interact with them. It was wonderful. And I think that's what makes it beautiful, that we have these leaders to follow and we can do this. These are my last few slides, and I was lucky that I am able to mentor these young people of Mumbai, who of course now are, you know, coming into their own, and they're becoming leaders of their own, and they are mentoring people. But I think it's beautiful the way the legacy is being passed along. And I think we need to thank this great society of Mumbai Obstetric Gynec Society, where this legacy is being passed from person to person. And I have to say thanks to my mom's family, you know, Asha Dalal, Narvekar, Dr. C.B. Purandre, for taking me into Amogs. And believe me, it's a beautiful family, and I'm enjoying it at the moment, being a part of the Marathi Mulgi that I am, and friends for life. I think our gynec fraternity has created friendships, and believe me, in this COVID times, I've realized that I'm talking a lot to all my friends and connecting with them. And it's beautiful. All of us have formed these friendships. And these friendships are the ones which we value and we will cherish as we grow older, and we realize that these are so important in life. And finally, my love and my unconditional support. I mean, my husband is amazing. I think ego is the death of life, my father says. And this is one man who is so proud. You know, he's been with me, he doesn't have an ego. He is so beautifully supported me, you know, right from the beginning. He was the one who, I don't have words. He is, and you know something, let me tell you something beautiful. In the last 8 months of COVID, I have fallen in love with him all over again. Because the last 20 years I've been running around, not being at home and all, but I've spent 8 months with him. And I've realized that I've fallen all over again in love with him. So he's a wonderful human being, and he's an amazing person, amazing person. And my family. I think Rohan takes after his father. So I'm very, very happy. And this young brigade on the right, they're the ones who are the source of my energy, you know. And I think my emojis year, which happened with all the new things that we launched, they were the source of all my inspiration. They were the ones who gave me all those ideas and got me moving with the different things and all. And of course, my Bloom team, I love them all and could not have achieved what they did. And loyalty. I think these three guys have given me unswearing loyalty. That is one thing I think we must develop in our life, is loyalty. Very, very important. Thank you, Amay. Thank you, Prateek. Thank you, Rohan. And my new role as glamour. I can't call myself grandmother, but glamour sounds good. And that is, you know, I'm enjoying with my granddaughter, Zuri, and it has really brought out the inner child in me. We fight, we play, we paint together. I'm a terrible painter, but I'm really enjoying. So I think empathy, clarity of values, trust, belief, passion, futuristic vision, out-of-box thinking, mentorship, unconditional support, loyalty. These are some of the things I feel I have learned in my life, and they have brought value to my life. And those are the things that would really help a lot of people. And I'm sure you've all had those qualities, and all the great people, the older people, have all these values. And I humbly bow to all of you all. Thank you. Thank you. And Sangeeta, thank you for giving me this opportunity. And I am very, very happy to be talking to all of you all. Thank you.
Wow, Nandita, that was absolutely fantastic. By giving us an insight into your life, you have given us so much food for thought, so many values to take home, so many things to ponder over and into implement into our lives. It was absolutely fantastic. And I think it was the most appropriate talk to begin this year with, because all of us need to get all the positivity back so that we can face the challenges of the life. So now, Amit, please unmute everybody. Let everybody talk.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, I'm sure everybody has loads of comments to make. So let's follow the same. First, your thumb up, please. Dr. Virkud wants to speak. So
just a minute, ma'am. Ma'am, now you can unmute yourself. Nandita, ma'am, please unmute. Sangeeta, ma'am, please unmute. Adi, sir, please unmute.
Let's raise your finger, thumb, so that we know who wants to talk. Dr. Virkud would like to comment. So please go ahead, sir.
Can you hear me, everyone?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. What should I say? I would say mentor of Nandita, I think I want to say the first thing. I'm one person who can talk very, very frankly about her, because not only do I know her, but I know her family also equally well. And one of the most important thing I feel is that I have taught her entire family, the OBGYN family. I've taught Nandita, I've taught her sister, and then later on, I've taught her next generation, and that is Rohan. And I know a lot about them. And I think Nandita knows this, and I've told it to, said it to her many times, that, you know, I've been a teacher, and I've had about 200 OBGYN students coming to my house for a year or more, learning OBGYN from me. Okay, and many of the, if you take most of the well-known gynecologists, obstetricians from Bombay, who have got children who have become OBGYN, starting from R.P. Sonawala to Tangs and the entire families, their children I have taught. Now, having said this, I've told this to Nandita, that of all the students that I have taught in my entire career, teaching them at home, I'm not talking of taking lectures in colleges, but they coming to my house where I come to know them very, very well, what they are and all that. Of all the students that I have taught, I said this, that Nandita Parshetkar is the most intelligent and most glamorous student I have taught in my life. And I've said this to her many times. And she, of course, takes it in a very, she just, you know, smiles about it and all that. But I really, really mean it. And she is one of the most intelligent students. And later on, I knew, I didn't say it to her at that time, but I knew it in my mind when I taught her that, yes, she is somebody who's going to achieve great things later on in life. And later on, she proved it. She did that. And I would send one or two small stories about her. When she used to come to my house, you know, and I used to teach her. And I, as she said, I like to teach very, very passionately. So we were supposed to teach each topic for about, say, 45 minutes to 1 hour. But sometime in a discussion, I used to just go on. And after some time, I realized that, you know, she used to get some sort of, she used to become restless or something. And then I asked her, what is happening? So she said, no, Pradeep is waiting for me. And I found out after some time that every time she used to come to my house, Pradeep, poor chap, used to wait down, and he used to come to pick her up. And sometimes he would wait for 45 minutes, half an hour. And I told Nandita, I said, why didn't you tell me? I'll wind up and all that. I said, ask him to come up and let him sit. And later on, then I got to know Pradeep, and he's such a nice person. He's one of the most sincere, honest person that I have seen, and a very, very, you know, lovable chap. And I really develop a good bond with him and his family. And then later on, I just taught Rohan, and that also I realized Rohan is also very, very smart. It's all it's all in your genes. But Nandita, having said this, I don't want to go too much into it. Just one more story. You know how you got into IVF, Nandita? I don't know whether you know this story now, because I don't know whether Rishikesh has told this to you. So basically, Nandita came to me for teaching or coaching at home because of Rishikesh. You know, one fine day, that time, Rishikesh said, Ajit, he called me up and he said, Ajit, I want to ask you something. I said, what? He said, no, I want to, there's one friend of mine, she's from JJ, and she's appearing for MD, and I want you to teach her. So I said, fine, no problem. I mean, who is she? So he said, no, she's Nandita Parshetkar, and she's D.Y. Patil's daughter. So I said, fine, I will teach her and all that. And I knew about D.Y. Patil because my brother-in-law is a politician and he knows them family-wise. So I said, fine. So, he taught me and all that. And then I taught her, she did well, she stood. And one more thing I used to say, always say, is that Nandita, if you had been there with a little longer, you would have definitely got the gold medal. She is gold medal material, and she knows it, and she later on proved it. But after she passed out and later on that, Rishikesh called me up some about say 6 months, 1 year later. He said, Ajit, अरे आता आय एम सेइंग इट इन मराठी बिकॉज द वे ही सेड इट असे अजित मी काय करू रे आता माझं झालं एम डी झालं आता सगळं झालं वी हॅव डन इट अँड थँक्यू फॉर यु नो टीचिंग नंदिता आता मी काय करू यु नो तो यु नो आय एम नॉट व्हेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ ऑप्टेटिक्स अँड आय एम नॉट व्हेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ सर्जरी तो आय थॉट ऑफ इट अँड आय सेड आय लेट थॉट थिंक ओवर इट अँड लेट यू नो सो ही कॉल मी अप अगेन अँड मी आय टोल्ड हिम आय से ऋषिकेश तू एक काम कर देर अ न्यू लाईन कमिंग विच इज आय व्ही एफ ई टी And that is something which requires a lot of capital, money and all that, which you have, okay? And it is something, and I also told him, I said, there's one more thing. It is not something which you can do alone. You should have a team and you should take Nandita with you and both of you should start. And of course, both of you have the financial background to do this, okay? And he said, yes, that's a good idea. I said, take it up and do it very, very sincerely, passionately. You will become it very soon because nobody has done it and you will become the leaders in IVF in ED. And Rishikesh, you know, luckily followed my advice and took it up and you know where they are today. And I'm really happy for giving them that advice, okay? So that is one thing I want to tell you. This is how you all became the IVF ET team and the leaders of IVF today in India. Because the advice which I gave you. So I'm really very, very happy that, you know, I could be of help to this family. And of course, there are many, many other stories, but I don't want to take too much of the time. I will let others speak. So Nandita, I'm very proud of you. Yeah. And I'll always be proud of you. You are the best student I've had. And, you know, may God bless your family and all the best to you in your future life.
Sangeeta, if you permit me one thing, one episode, yes, I would like. You know, Dr. Saraya is here. I want to say, you know, she had given me a paper. I was in Kalamkar's unit and she had given me a paper to read. I was a student in Dr. Kalamkar and she had given me a paper to read because I was there and I read her paper and she taught me over there. And I actually got the first prize for that paper. With her training and everything. And I can't believe it because that was my first paper which I read. And Dr. Saraya, I will never ever forget that because that was my foray into public speaking. So thank you very much for the opportunity that you gave because that was my first opportunity in my career which you gave me. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Who would like to speak? Dr. Aspir Emelwala, how come you're so quiet? You have some sore throat or something?
No, I'm in awe with looking at Nandita, you know. I'm actually speechless looking at Nandita.
Because we don't feel normal if you're quiet, no? It looks like the network barabar nahi hai ki kya ho gaya idhar.
I remember, I think so, Nandita, about 20, 25 years back, you walked in my consulting room with Dinesh, if I am not mistaken.
Yes.
And you were contesting your first election, if I am also not mistaken there. And believe me, that is one vote which I casted for Nandita. After that, I must have casted hundreds of votes, even to BJP or this, that and all. That one vote which was counted in favor of Nandita, I have never, ever regretted that, you know. And it was so wonderful and so nice. And at that time also, even I thought it to be so, as people were saying that yeah, this girl is going to be at a greater height than what it is. She is so down to earth personality, lovable person, to her husband, to her children, granddaughter and everybody. Nandita, nice to be in everybody's life, all around your friends and family. Thank you so very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to say two, three things. First of all, Nandita, I always look upon her as my extended sister, extended family. And she mentioned about ego. I would like to say one thing that, as she's also rightly said, we all imbibe a lot of values from our parents. But I feel ego is something that not only her husband, but I feel even she doesn't have an ego, you know, because sometimes we feel that, you know, it's very difficult to approach, especially the kind of positions that she's held. It's not easy for somebody to just approach her like this, but not only she's my friend, but from my contemporaries also. Whenever you call, you know, even if she's busy, she'll make it a point to answer the phone and she'll say, okay, Even if she's tied up, she'll say, I'll get back to you. And she does get back, which is a rare trait I see in people because they royally forget. That is one thing, very approachable, very down to earth. She's remained grounded in spite of everything that she's achieved in life. And I think that's an awesome trait. Hats off to you. And the other thing which I'd like to borrow from you, I'm telling you blatantly, plagiarism, glamour. When I become a grandmother, I'm going to tell my grandchildren, call me glamour.
Absolutely.
Love it. Thank you.
I absolutely second what Sandhya said. Even, you know, with my own experience, I am part of MOGS, but I'm not inside. But I have felt it so many times that there are so many people you feel that, you know, they connect with you only for the vote and then there is total bye-bye. But Nandita, I must say, is one person who never ever changed before and after the vote. You surely have 100% marks for that thing. You know, I've always noticed it. Ki she was same before and after. She's always been friendly, down to earth, approachable. And I absolutely second what Sandhya said. But I won't choose the glamour part because that won't be required. But I wish I could be as even little glamorous like you. But hum log ko wo apne aap ko waisa carry karna aata hi nahi hai. Aur aayega bhi nahi. It's too late in life now for it.
Never too late.
It's never too late. Yeah.
Never too late.
Yeah. I can say something.
Can I say a word for Nandita?
Yes, sir. After sir, Dr. Sujata Dalvi. For Dr. Dastur, please go ahead.
I remember coming for your first opening of the clinic in Bombay Mutual Terrace. And I saw what Ajit was saying also, that you know the force you had behind it. And I knew that it will be successful. That's why from that day I began calling you Nandita, pulsating. Because I found you pulsating, I found you full of energy and you believed in what you want to do. And Rishikesh was a good balance. He kept you, you know, he kept you sane. He didn't let you go and you know, transfer 50 embryos or something. So he was holding on to you and you both made a very good pair. And throughout your career, I've been watching you. I watch many of the youngsters who are coming out. You've set a very good example. Very good example to your juniors, to your colleagues, to your peers and everybody, and even to your seniors. And you really conducted yourself well. Glamour is a part of everybody. So that's okay. That you have the glamour, which is good, but you have the brains behind the glamour. Very few beautiful women, glamorous, have brains. They don't have much brains. So you have a combination which is very unbeatable.
Adi, so be stay, careful.
Huh?
Adi, be careful. There are so many women here.
No, but I'm telling what I feel about her. So she's the focus just now. And therefore, I'm directing my words to her directly. And I know that whatever you pick up in the future also, you'll do well. And you bent on doing well because your outlook in life. Now I understand your mantras, as you've said your whole story in parts, that you've been fortunate to have people who are with empathy, with good qualities, with a satisfied mind. So you mentioned about people who are rich, who are poor, who are successful. What you need is a satisfied mind. And I sent you a song today evening by Joan Baez, which is called A Satisfied Mind, which exactly suits you. So I'll send that song to you today evening. All the best. Keep on getting more and more babies in this world and keep on being the person you are. God bless you. Not at all. All the best.
Thank you.
Dr. Sujata.
Yeah. Thank you, Sangeeta. I would like to say I came in contact with Nandita after I was introduced by Dr. Rishikesh Pai. Because Rishi is my classmate. We have been together right from first MBBS onwards. We were co-houseman and registrar and everything. And that's how I came in contact. And second thing was Pradeep and Nandita, because Rohan and my son have been classmates right from KG till the 10th standard. We would meet almost 3 times in a year for the PTA meeting, you know, parent teachers meeting. Of course, Nandita at time would be busy, but Pradeep would always be there, you know. And both of them are so, they have no ego. They're so grounded as such that we would always talk and this and that and everything. And we would constantly at least meet at least about 3 times in a year. Third thing, whenever I used to go and operate in Dr. Nandita's nursing home at Opera House, everything was so balanced and everything. She was so much approachable. The staff is so good. Even Pradeep would come and supervise, and everything is absolutely down to earth. I must tell you that, you know, that anything you want to talk to them, they're always open to everything. So my hats off to her. And when she was a president of Foxy, gave me lots of opportunity to travel all over India, included me in so many programs and everything. So I must thank Dr. Nandita for whatever opportunities that was given to me as a Foxy president. Thank you so much, Nandita.
Dr. Uture, please unmute yourself.
Yeah. Nandita, it's so good to know so many additional things in your life, additional events in your life, and the milestones of your life. I'm really lucky to be your friend, and to have a friend like this is really an amazing thing. I consider myself very lucky. Thank you. Thank you, Sangeeta.
Thank you.
No, don't thank me. There's nothing to thank me for. Dr. Ameya, please unmute yourself.
I'm one of the team Nandita members, as she calls it. And my entry into the team was a very, very exceptional entry, because I was told by one of my friends that Dr. Nandita wants to, is considering that you should be her joint secretary. And listen, you cannot open your mouth in front of her. You have to keep quiet. And everything that she says, you have to be a yes man. Now, and I would be meeting her in the next few days to discuss about the Foxy year. So I was in extreme turmoil, because if I don't speak, I cannot voice my opinion. And I would be useless if I would just be a yes man. So I told my wife, I don't think I need to be frank with her and tell her that I wouldn't be the ideal person to take up that position. In the next 2 or 3 days, we happened to meet. And I was very quiet, because it was a big post that she was going to occupy. And if I was to be on the team, I was told that, no, you have to shut up and say yes to everything that she says. So I was very quiet, and for the first 10 minutes. And she asked me openly, why are you so quiet? She realized, you know, she has this pulse. She can pick up what the person is thinking. I said, madam, can I be frank with you? So she said, yes. So I said, so-and-so has told me that I'm supposed to shut up and say yes to whatever. He said, no, you cannot be like that. You have to be yourself. I want you on the team because I have seen what you are and what you are capable of. And so if you are not able to express yourself, you can't deliver whatever I want you to deliver. And she allowed me a free hand. She listened to my comments, sometimes critical comments, because she knew that I always had her best interests at heart. Most importantly, she allowed my creativity to grow. And like Dr. Virkut said, and Dr. Adi Dastur said, she is a satisfied soul. She's never insecure. And she believes in mentoring her juniors and being that important part in their lives, which they will treasure all their life, and will allow them to grow. Even today, when I look back at our Foxy year, I realize that we might have conceptualized a lot of things together. And I always tell her that it is because of her final push and her connect with people, her love and warmth with people, that we were able to amplify our efforts. So for me, she is amplification and love and warmth, which just makes her so successful, be it with her patients, be it with her professional colleagues, be it with her organization, and be it with her family. In spite of her professional busy schedule, she always connects with her family. It is something that is on top priority, whether it be the Patils or whether it be the Palshetkars. So madam, there is a lot to learn from you. And I think that as juniors, we need to listen to what you have to say today, that we should never keep ego in our careers or in our lives. If we are humble, honest, and humane, I think we will be able to emulate you in the true sense of the word. Thank you so much for being there in my life and giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
Amai, thank you so much. Amai lived with me for 1 year. I mean, he would just come whenever I wanted. Thank you, Amay, and the loyalty. That was only one thing I asked him. I said, are you willing to be loyal to me? Then you work with me.
Well said, Amay. Everything was well said.
Pradeep was standing behind Nandita and waving out. So see how much he supports her, you know. I must tell you that.
Yeah, actually, I was about to say that we saw him standing behind you.
Yeah, like, that's right. You know.
So why don't you call him and let us all say hi to him?
Yeah.
Pradeep, he's disappeared. If he comes back, I'll call him.
So, madam told my wife, I'm taking your husband away for 1 year. Okay. Don't expect that he will be, you know, he will be totally into Foxy 2019. And I thank her for all the help and all the support and encouragement.
Today is Foxy Foundation Day, by the way, Sangeeta.
Oh, congrats. And I remember you gave us a good breakfast from Vinayak in Foxy office with Piyush and everything, you know, misal pav and vada pav. Hi, Pradeep.
Pradeep, Nandita, you're looking a nice pair.
Color coordinated.
Pair. Coordinated.
This photo shoot is.
Picture, Amit.
Yeah.
Picture.
Pradeep has lost a lot of weight.
Yeah. Thank you.
Behind every successful woman, there is a man.
Hey, yeah. Bipin, hi.
Yeah.
I think Dr. Shilpa wants to make a comment. Shilpa, you are raising your finger.
Madam, thank you very much. You were the MOGS president and I was the youth council member. And I think I did the fashion work for that year only because you encouraged everyone. And it was really, and you were knowing each one by their name. I think that is very, very important, madam. That you were like, Shilpa, you do this. Shilpa, you do this. So that was, you know, you connect with everyone. So thank you so much, madam. That was really wonderful. That year was very great. Thank you so much, ma'am.
I think we all had a lovely time.
Yes, definitely.
Sangeeta, I want to say one thing, if you allow me, because I've already spoken a lot. Is there anybody else who wants to say? Otherwise, I want to say one thing. Okay. Hello. Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe my internet is a little choppy. Okay. Can you hear me? Because I can see myself now.
Yeah.
Okay. So I've said this one more thing to Nandita. She knows it, but I would say it very sort of, you know, make something like a declaration about her. So everybody's talked about her empathy and her qualities and her success and her glamour and all that. But she has one more thing which she has acquired genetically, which many of you may have perceived, but I have perceived it a lot. And I've told this to Nandita. Nandita, you are a born politician. Okay, I've seen a lot of good political qualities in you. Of course, you have achieved everything in all the medical bodies that we have, Foxy, IAG, ISAR, UB, FISAR, ISAR, UB. Okay, now I told Sangeeta, now it's time for you to go at the state and national level. I want Nandita to enter, you know, state level and, you know, national level politics. And she will make a fantastic health minister. I've told this to her. I said, Nandita, go for it. You know, of course, it's a very tough thing. It's a this thing, which party you join and what you do. Of course, that's up to you. But you must enter politics and you will become a very, very good politician. We need good politicians like you, Nandita. And
we'll
form
a gynec party. All of you should be there with the campaigning.
Yes, of course, I will give. And I have a lot of political background myself. I will help you in whatever you can. But we need good politicians like you. And we need somebody to represent our OBGYN community, Nandita. And you are the person of all the 30,000 of gynecologists that we have in India. Nandita is the person who I feel should enter
Sure.
I know Nandita doesn't like it. She never acknowledges whatever I tell her. But Nandita, you are a born politician. Let me tell you, that cannot change.
Sure.
you have that quality in you. And I've seen it, and I've seen sticks of that even in Rohan. Let me tell you, I've seen it. I know you all so well as a family, so closely, and that's what I want to tell you. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sangeeta. Dr. Kamat, to me far Shantat. I've come to each and everyone's clinic. You know, I've visited each and everyone's clinic over here.
You had come with my dear friend Salgaonkar.
Yes.
That has continued with your son. He too came, and I told him, no need. After the generation, the next has come. So that's
really I know. Cool. How is your son doing, sir?
Yeah, they're doing well.
Bipin, kasa is?
Bas, theek. Tujhya baddal kay bolnar?
नको बोलू काय
शब्द कमी पडतात
गाणं गा सगळ्यांसाठी
शब्द कमी पडणार
संगीता मॅडम
प्रदीप बद्दल बोलू शकतो तुझ्या बद्दल बोलायला कठीण आहे
काय
कॅन आय से समथिंग जस्ट अ स्मॉल दिस थिंग
सो
संगीता मॅम कॅन आय से समथिंग सो इन द फॉक्सी इयर इवन दो एव्हरीथिंग लुक्ड रोजी अँड थिंग्स लाईक दॅट देर वर टाइम्स लाईक when we were really anxious. And I always tell madam that, madam, you have Rajyog. Because every challenge that we had, every difficulty we had, we thought, you know, where would we get the money? Who would be the contact? We had many dreams and ambitions to, as far as community health was concerned. And madam used to just be very quiet. Of course, internally, she might have also been tense, but she never exhibited it to the team. And somebody, believe you, me, somebody just walked into her room or her in office, and that problem used to get solved. So I've seen this repeatedly happen. It can't be a coincidence. I always tell her, madam, you have Rajyog. Just somebody comes, you have that divine helper somewhere, that angel who comes and helps us out of any crisis that we have to face. I mean, it's something very, very special, some quality that she has. She just attracts that person. He comes and out of nowhere, he goes out of the way and helps us. So
I think, Amay, you know what? Foxy has become a brand today with all the work that all the past presidents have done. They have really worked very hard. And today, Foxy has become a brand. So there are a lot of people who are coming and wanting to work with Foxy, with MOGS. Of course, we were lucky, definitely.
Madam, I don't agree with that. I think they came because you were the front face. It's somebody they believed in, who would carry their message, who they could trust with their money or with their sponsorship, etc. And that's why they came out of nowhere.
So, Sangeeta, thank you. Thank you, Amma. I'm very embarrassed by all this.
Health Minister. दोस्तों को ज्वाइन करना दोस्तों
But let me tell you, Dr. Adi Dastur, in my life, no, there was this stranger, absolute stranger who didn't know who I was. You know, my registration was cancelled, Dr. Dastur, MD registration. And I didn't know what to do. I got a letter from the university saying your registration is cancelled. You won't believe it. At that point, the vice chancellor of the Bombay University used to eat khana with my father. Okay, I used to call him Kaka. But I don't know what it, as Amay says, it's luck, intuition or whatever. I did not tell him. I just did not approach him. I took that letter and I went to Bombay University. You know, I don't even remember that registrar's name. I was Nandita Palshetkar that time. I was not even Patel or anything. I went to him and I gave him the letter and I said, look, I have a son and my mother-in-law passed away and I had to leave my post and I had to come back. That time, you know, I was doing a studentship mat with Dr. Uta Saraya, and then I did that 6 months and I had to leave. And I went to the university and the stranger, out of just kindness of his heart, sir. He said, okay. And he reversed the order without anything. He didn't ask me who I was, what I was, nothing. You know, that also has made me, Sangeeta, you know, asked me, will you help? I will help anybody and anyone if anybody asks me. Because that incident in my life, that man just helped me, Sangeeta, without a word, without asking any favor, without doing anything. I mean, he changed my life. probably if I was not a gynec, I would have been with my father and, you know, into D.Y. Patil and all those things. Different. My life would have taken a different turn. But, you know, teachers do strange things for you. So I think if you have an ability to do something for somebody, just do it. You know, it changes people's lives. Yeah.
Keep on doing it, Nandita.
Yeah, you have to. Yeah, you have to just do it for people.
I always, as I mentioned earlier, you are always the one who were never had an ego. Okay.
No, it's not the question. Yeah, I know ego. Ego, to Baba, my father keeps saying ego is the death of life. Ego is the death of life. But anyway, this was really nice, and I feel very, very good today. Thank you very much for this. Thank you very much.
All the best to you in the future. Words,
Dr. Vipul, God bless. Thank you,
Dr. Bistu.
Pradeep, all the best to you, Pradeep.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Saraya. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, everybody.
And Happy New Year to everyone. Happy New Year to everyone in person.
Amai, how are the children?